Hi, alle sammen. Hello, everyone. Today we will talk about how to use the prepositions til, and for in Norwegian. If you're learning Norwegian, you may have encountered the prepositions til, and for. These two words can be tricky to master, especially for non-native speakers. In our discussion today, we'll explore the different ways til, and for are used in Norwegian and provide tips to help you use them correctly. Before we dive into the use of til, and for, it's essential to understand the basics of prepositions in Norwegian. Like in English, prepositions in Norwegian are words that link nouns or pronouns to other elements in a sentence. They provide information about an action or event's position, direction, or time. In Norwegian, prepositions can be divided into two categories, simple and compound. Compound prepositions have two or more words, while simple prepositions only have one. Til, and for are simple prepositions in Norwegian. Til is one of the most commonly used prepositions in Norwegian. It can have several meanings depending on the context. Here are some of the most common uses of til in Norwegian. Til is often used to indicate direction or movement towards a specific place or person. For example, jeg skal til Oslo i morgen. Jeg skal til Oslo i morgen. Jeg skal til Oslo i morgen. I'm going to Oslo tomorrow. Kan du gi denne boken til henne? Kan du gi denne boken til henne? Kan du gi denne boken til henne? Can you give this book to her? Til can also indicate a specific time or deadline. For example, jeg må være ferdig med rapporten til onsdag. Jeg må være ferdig med rapporten til onsdag. Jeg må være ferdig med rapporten til onsdag. I have to finish the report by Wednesday. Vi må være på flyplassen til klokka 12. Vi må være på flyplassen til klokka 12. Vi må være på flyplassen til klokka 12. We have to be at the airport by noon. Til can be used to indicate the purpose or intention of an action. For example, jeg kjøpte blomster til min kjæreste. Jeg kjøpte blomster til min kjæreste. Jeg kjøpte blomster til min kjæreste. I bought flowers for my girlfriend. Til can be used to indicate the purpose of an intention, but also it can be used as a comparison, to show comparison. So, for example, we can say, han stor til å være 5 år. Han stor til å være 5 år. Han stor til å være 5 år. He's big for a 5-year-old. Norge har en liten befolkning til å være et land. Norge har en liten befolkning til å være et land. Norge har en liten befolkning til å være et land. Norway has a small population for a country. Now we will discuss how we can use for in Norwegian. Here are some of the most common uses of for. For can indicate the purpose or reason for an action. For example, jeg spiser salat for å være sunn. Jeg spiser salat for å være sunn. Jeg spiser salat for å være sunn. I eat salad to be healthy. Jeg leser boken for å lære norsk. Jeg leser boken for å lære norsk. Jeg leser boken for å lære norsk. I'm reading the book to learn Norwegian. For can also be used to indicate a specific time period in the past. For example, for 2 dager siden var jeg i Bergen. For 2 dager siden var jeg i Bergen. For 2 dager siden var jeg i Bergen. 2 days ago I was in Bergen. For 5 år siden bodde jeg i Danmark. For 5 år siden bodde jeg i Danmark. For 5 år siden bodde jeg i Danmark. 5 years ago I lived in Denmark. For can also be used to express comparison or contrast. For example, det er varmt for å være denne tiden på året. Det er varmt for å være på denne tiden av året. Det er varmt for å være på denne tiden av året. For can express a benefit or advantage of something. For example, det er bra for helsen din å spise frukt. Det er bra for helsen din å spise frukt. Det er bra for helsen din å spise frukt. It's good for your health to eat fruit. Det er viktig for karrieren din å ha en utdannelse. Det er viktig for karrieren din å ha en utdannelse. Det er viktig for karrieren din å ha en utdannelse. It's important for your career to have an education. Even though till and for have clear and distinct uses in Norwegian, learners often make mistakes when using them. Here are some of the most common mistakes to avoid. One of the most common mistakes is to confuse till with for. Remember that till usually means 2 words or towards something, and for on the other side usually means for a reason or a benefit. So there's a distinction here. In conclusion, the Norwegian prepositions til, and for are very important and can be used differently depending on the situation. By understanding the different meanings and practicing their use, you can master the correct use of these prepositions in Norwegian. And then another mistake that we see is that to use for For instead of till, to indicate direction or movement towards something. For example, jeg skal til London. Jeg skal til London. Jeg skal til London. I'm going to London. It's correct. Well, jeg skal for London. Jeg skal for London. Jeg skal for London. I'm going for London. It's not. Do you want to learn more Norwegian? We are now offering a free Norwegian trial class. Sign up for a free trial class by going to our website, nlsnorwegian.no. nlsnorwegian.no.